Friday, June 11th, 2021, Maneco 64, home of alternative economics and contrarian views. So there are signs out there, in my opinion, that the bullion banks are in trouble. They've got a short position they can't extricate themselves from. Alistair McLeod recently covered the commitment of traders and how the net short position on COMEX is increasing as the price looks like it wants to break out. So why do I say that? Well, because I've learned from history. I've been around for a while, and I know that when Gordon Brown pre-announced the sale of half of the UK's gold reserves in 1999, the excuse was that they wanted to have diversified their reserves into the new euro that was coming out around that time. They wanted to streamline the country's reserves. And then years later, we found out that a lot of the bullion banks in London were in trouble at the time. And the pre-announcement was made so that the price would drop and that the bullion banks could cover. And I've made videos about this before, how one of Gordon Brown's, who at the time, of course, was the Chancellor of the Exchequer in the UK, had a very close advisor, economic advisor, who later became head of the BBC, who was a partner at Goldman Sachs. And at the time, Goldman Sachs was looking to go public to do their IPO. And the rumor is, and I can't prove that, of course, but it makes sense. The rumor was that Goldman Sachs and others were in trouble. They had a huge short position in gold. Gold had spiked at the time to $300 an ounce. And after the pre-announcement, gold fell. So now we've got the president of France, Macron, at the G7 meeting here in the UK, urging G7 countries to sell gold reserves to fund a bailout for Africa, which is, in my opinion, another cover for the bullion banks. The other thing I would say, Gordon Brown has been a very close friend and has had Evelyn de Rothschild as an advisor. We know that Emmanuel Macron, the president of France, worked for the Rothschilds in Paris and made millions for working there a few years. So am I saying it's the Rothschilds that are in trouble with the bullion banks? No, I'm saying that they have a lot of influence, these people. And I would bet that this is a cover story because you don't really need to sell gold reserves to help Africa. And if anything, Africa has a lot of resources. And if you pre-announce a gold sale, you might hurt the gold market, but I don't think that will happen this time. What I'm trying to say, it's a cover and it's a signal. And people call when Gordon Brown pre-announced the gold sales, sold half the reserves, which weren't much anyway, 600 tons, he sold 300. We have in the UK, the reserves left are about 310 tons. They call it the brown bottom. So why was it a bottom? Well, because I think the bullion banks got away with it, covered their shorts, and probably went long. And I would say this is a pretty bullish signal as well. And yes, so the story came out yesterday. I'm not going to go through it exactly. They could very easily print the money or create some more SDRs from the IMF, which they're already giving to Africa. So yes, that's what happens when you've been following the gold market for so long, when you've done a lot of research. You put two and two together. And I noticed someone tweeted out yesterday, or there's a story noting that Canada as well sold a lot of their reserves around 2016 when gold was pretty much near its post 2011 low as well. So with that, just a few more things about the CPI yesterday. Yes, I said that I expected to be a lot higher than expected, and it was 5%. And one amazing thing that I saw, well, you might not think it's amazing, but interesting thing. So yesterday, Stanley Druckenmiller, who's one of the most famous hedge fund managers, is worth over $5 billion, started his career out with George Soros. He actually sent an email to CNBC, and he said that the Federal Reserve is canceling the market signals. That's a euphemism for the Fed is manipulating the markets. Yeah, and it was amazing because I started out in the markets in the late 80s. I worked in the bond market. I worked in the currency market. I followed every asset class. And if we had had a number, or it's the last 2 months, we've seen CPI be higher than expected. I think last month it was expected to come out at 3.2, came out at 3.6. This month was expected 4.6, came out at 5. If it had been the other way around and CPI was really low, the Fed would have already probably cut rates and started QE. But they're just sitting on their hands. They're not going to raise rates. They're not going to taper. They're probably going to keep doing more and more QE, more printing, more yield curve control. Because if they try to reverse, everything will implode. And if it does implode, they'll quickly throw everything at it again. So what was so manipulated, or as Mr. Druckenmiller said yesterday, what was canceled yesterday? What market signals? First, I think gold and silver were canceled. They were smashed down prior to the number. They probably knew the number, of course, the traders at the New York Fed. Yes, and they did rebound later, and they are a bit firmer this morning. The reason they do this canceling is that on the day they want investors and the public to see it's not bad because gold was down. You know, this CPI is going to be transitory, this rise. But the other thing, the biggest cancellation, in my opinion, having worked in the bond market for over 20 years, was the fact that the 10-year yield actually dropped below 150. It's crazy. Back in the day when I was in the bond markets, let's say in the early to mid 90s, if we had a number like this, even though at the time CPI was usually higher than now, there would have been a big sell-off in the bond market. But the Fed is kind of not just canceled signals, but it's manipulated people's perception of the market. Of course, people like Druckenmiller don't buy into it. So like this morning, as I speak here in London, it's 8 a.m. London, the 10-year yield continues to fall. We've got also the CRB index, which measures all the major commodities, at a 6-year high. and people are buying bonds and treasuries. I would say it's more the central bank manipulating it. But don't forget, in the short term, speculators make money as bond prices go up, yields go down. But even, let's say, if we give the Federal Reserve the benefit of the doubt that this CPI rise or inflationary pressures are transitory and we come back down to, let's say, 2%, why would you want to still invest in a 10-year at less than 1.5%. So these markets are crazy. The Fed is creating a lot of dangers out there, I think, and things could come out of left field and really hurt a lot of investors. And that's another reason why I keep a hold of my physical gold and silver outside the system. Yes, I do have some savings in the system, in the mining sector, of course, that's at risk a little bit, but I'm quite comfortable. It's a risk that I'm willing to take and sleep with. I sleep soundly with it. But yes, I think, as the Austrians say, It's creating a lot of malinvestment. It's creating another housing bubble, not just in the US, but in Canada, in Australia, in the UK. It doesn't make any sense. And it always ends in tears. Let's quickly look at where the markets are this morning. It's 8 a.m. London time. We've got spot gold testing the 1900 level. We're at 1901, up just over $3. Yes, yesterday it was hit hard before the CPI number. We went down to 1869. The high overnight has been 1902, the low 1892. At least silver is doing well this morning. We're breaking through 28. We're actually at 28.20, up 22 cents, or almost 1% higher, 0.79% higher. The Dow is down 13 points this morning, the Dow future. I noticed yesterday as well, after the CPI number, before the regular hour market opened, we saw the futures up 150. So, and gold down about $10 or $15. So they're trying to manage the perception before the major, you know, before investors came online at 9:30 a.m. New York. So the NASDAQ 100 futures up 7, S&P is down 1. So yeah, stock market actually didn't do very well yesterday. It gave up a lot of the gains it had during the day. Maybe people are waking up to the fact that not all is well with the economy, even though the Fed's trying to make it look very good. And as I said as well, the CRB index is moving higher. We are at a six-year high, so commodities are doing quite well. We're going to look at them before we go into the currencies. We got WTI crude trading at 70. It's pretty much unchanged. We got high-grade copper up about 1% at 453. What about lumber? I had a look at the chart of lumber. Yes, it's corrected quite a bit, but I think there's some support a little lower in lumber, and I think it could still surprise us, even though I, to be honest, I don't follow the fundamentals of that market too much. I know what's happened in the last 12 months as people move out of the big cities, but yeah, I think lumber, aside from being something related with house building, it could also be related with the death of the dollar. People want real things. And the dollar index as well. I think that's very close to breaking through some key technical levels on the downside. And I think that's going to be around 89.50. If we break through that area, I think, the dollar could be in trouble. The key level on the downside from a few years ago is 88.25. Yeah, so I think higher commodities are pointing to a weaker dollar as well. And as I said, the Feds continue to sit on their hands. We got rates at virtually zero. We've got the CPI going up at 5%. We've got commodities at six-year highs. You'd expect the Fed maybe to have an emergency meeting to raise rates, but I guess we're going to have to wait till next week. Their next meeting starts on Wednesday and ends on Thursday. Quickly look at the currencies this morning. We've got sterling down a little bit at 141.66. The euro is up 0.1% at 121.88. Dollar is unchanged versus the yen at 109.35. Dollar is at 6.3848, so a little stronger versus the yuan. And Aussie dollar right now, Aussie dollar is quite strong, actually. It's trading at recent highs of the last few weeks. It's up 0.2% at 77.68. And that equates to the commodities doing really well. I think the Aussie dollar now could be set to trade up to around 78 and eventually even 80 versus the dollar. So there you go. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button. Please share it far and wide. Think about subscribing to my channel if you haven't yet. And you can also follow me on all these platforms below here. I wish you all a great Friday and a great weekend. Take care. Bye.